tell you a story. We are in a school, and as the first thing, there is a mistress mm-hmm. and pupils, 8 years, 10 years. And the mistress go to the board, blackboard, and she draw a tree. And she said to the pupil, in this tree, there is 10 birds. A hunter pass and kill tree. How many birds stay in the tree? And in the first row, a young girl said, I know, 7. Bravo, says the mistress. That is mathematics, subtraction. Bravo. But at the last row, a young guy said, no, madam. No, mistress. They are don't mad the bird. When they see their friend, they are killed, they go out. It just remain 0 birds. And the mistress say, I love your way of thinking. You have a direct way, different way of thinking. But mathematics is rational. You are a poet. Stay the poet and become a little more rational. And the little boy say, okay, I give you a problem. In a garden, there is 3 ladies sit in a bank. The first one eat an ice. The second one lick an ice. And the third one suck an ice. Who is the married woman? And the mistress say, I think it's the number 3. Not at all, says the young boy. It's the one who have a ring. But I love your way of thinking. That is great. That is great.
Yeah. You once said that the 2-second ad would be the future of advertising. You said once that the 2-second ad would be the future of advertising. You still believe that? It was around 2010, I think.
But the future of advertising is short and long. We enter in the content agency. In Havas now was the number one content agency in the world. We merged with Vivendi. And we've made 20 billion a year of advertisement and content in the world. We are number one, more than WPP and Publicis mm-hmm. join. Because we have content of TV with Canal Plus, we have content of movie with Studio Canal, we have content of music, 40% with our company of music, Universal Music. 40% of the singers in the world are in Universal. And we have content, we have a lot of video games. And we have content of advertising. And we, in 2 years now, we built a big village in Paris. We 10 or 12,000 creatives from all these companies mixed mm-hmm. in a village. It's a Navas village. Mm-hmm. Number one Havas village in the world to work together. That is the future of this job. Hmm. And now we have 2 categories of agency. We have the agency, we believe the future is in technology, like WPP and like Publicis. And they buy for a lot of money, and they have a lot of debt, silot of digital and other things totally out of fashion today. So you see, you look at the problem of the UPP. They fire $3, Sir Sorel. Not because he make love in a plane, because the shareholder is 15% down, and he don't understand what happens. And Publicis, same thing, has a lot of problems because it's a lot of things. And the future of that is like Omnicom. And we try, we are so small, but we try to do in the same, to work in the same way. Omnicom is the only group for the last 2 years, we don't lose money, we win money. Why? because they don't believe in digital. They make digital. The digital is today, tomorrow is another thing. It's artificial intelligence, after is another thing. So only the ID stay the same all around the century. And so the number one now in grow is Omnicom, because they have the three best, you know that, the three best creative agency in the world. And the GAFA are killing our job. And I think in 15 years, maybe before, 50% of the agency in the world today are dying. Why? Because last year, 100% of the increase in investment in advertising go to the GAFA. I write a book against that. The devil is s'habille en GAFA, comme on dit. The devil is dressed by in GAFA. And to write that, because until now we have like adversary all the agency, and they will fight like football, and the best win. But now it's totally that. It's mountain of dollars against us. And after the GAFA, we have the agency, the consultancy agency, like Deloitte or this big one, who create their own creative agency. And they create seven creative agencies last year, Deloitte, to make, after the marketing of the brand, the creativity of the brand. After that, we have the client who internalize the new discipline, the discipline of big data, the discipline of artificial intelligence, and they do that himself. So our market is like that. Okay? And after that, the consumer, who 50% of the consumer in the world don't look at advertising yet. Why? Because in the social media, it's a bullshit. It's awful. It's only the contrary of creativity. Everybody thinks I am advertising and put that. And they just hate. It's never love. It's just hate. It's aggressive. It's no quality at all. It's not aesthetic. It's a torrent de merde. It's a shit torrent. Now, we need, if we don't fight all together, all the big groups, we don't fight against that. And if the government don't fight against the GAFA, in 10 years, the GAFA become more powerful than America. Today, the GAFA is more powerful than the French. They have the PBIs of the French.
Yeah.
And nobody says nothing. Nobody makes nothing. And they have no idea. They have just money. And what money? Because they pick our data. And nobody, I am the only guy in France who say, it's crazy, protect your data. They make money with you. And tomorrow, we kill you. Because what? Who gives the money to the GAFA to become the GAFA advertising? Us, our client. That is the real fight of today.
What do you think about this?
My poor English?
Yeah. Well, we are in a very interesting moment. When I started in advertising, the agencies had inside research, promotions, media, creativity. Creativity was already the core of the business, but I mean, we work with research in a very profitable way. And after that, first we created these silos that to me was one of the worst decisions in the history of advertising, media in one side, research in other. Now where we are is probably because the power of data, that is coming and still is starting, but will be huge, will change everything. We need to put everything again together. And we are doing, of the big groups, we are doing this, putting physically, emotionally, professionally, everything together. Still there are some silos in this that it's not easy to put them working together, but at the end, to me, advertising in the future will be a huge services, including creativity in all of them, no? Creativity plus data, no, creativity in all the process, a huge capability that we will work in content, as you mentioned, in production, in advertising, classical advertising, in, will be, as a whole, I mean, the agency will be not as you know the agency, today, nothing compared with this. The only point that probably we still will have is the client will be in the center. You will probably, one person in contact with the client talking about all the big strategies as a brand, but the brand will be not in advertising all, will be in all the journey of the client, all the journey of the consumer from the first day to the end, and the agencies must be with in this journey, in all the process with the consumer. That means being in what he do, what he talk, what is his behavior in social networks, etc., etc., and putting the brand in terms of content, in terms of creativity, and in terms of media. During this process in the most effective way.
What do you think, Cisco? Is this still creativity, this business?
Well, I don't know exactly how will be the future. No idea the future of advertising. But I basically agree with Miguel and with Jax. The idea is, or at least I think, it will be the future of creativity and the future of advertising. Because all the technologies around, all the social media, all the things that are happening at the moment, even artificial intelligence, everything, all the technologies, we are in this hype, no, of the things, mm-hmm. Even data, no, of course, brands could arrive to personalize the advertising one to one, okay? But at the end, brands has to differentiate also, and at the end, you have to arrive to the heart of the people with emotions and to touch the heart of the people, because if not, people you think. If you are receiving a message for you, you think you will be loyal to this brand. This is an error. This is false. Completely false. People are not loyal to brands. In fact, people. I think it was an investigation from Abbas that says that. People doesn't matter if the 89% of the brands disappear tomorrow.
Yeah.
So, people, if there are no brands, it's okay for the people. There will be another way to buy products or services or whatever. So at the moment.